Hello, and welcome back to another Eduonics tutorial. In this section, we're going over photo correction in Photoshop, and in this video, we'll be performing a double RAW conversion. These days, most good digital cameras will provide you with a variety of file types to work with. Some of these are very simple, like JPEGs. JPEGs are great because they're compressed to a low file size and are quickly ready to share. But there are also more complex file types that aren't compressed. Instead, they allow you to change the raw properties of the photo even after you've taken it. Photoshop makes a program that allows you to manipulate these raw photos, called Camera Raw. Camera Raw pairs with Photoshop, and it's an essential feature for the serious digital photographer. But Camera Raw isn't exclusive to raw photos. I'm going to show you how to pull just a regular JPEG into Camera Raw and perform a double RAW conversion. I'm going to open my photo. Usually, I would go up to File, Open, but that's not going to open my photo in Camera Raw. Instead, I'm going to go down to Open As. Here's my photo right here. I'm going to select it, and you can see that it's just a regular JPEG if you look in the file name. Then I'll go over here and click this box on the right that says Photoshop. When I click this, it's going to pull up a whole menu of file types. And I'm going to go down and click the one that starts with Camera Raw. Then I'll click Open. Okay, now we are in the Camera Raw window. Up here on top, there's a bunch of tools. And over here on the right, there's a lot of different sliders. I'm not going to use any of these just yet. Instead, I want to continue to open this in Photoshop. But before I click this Open Image button, I'll press and hold the Shift key. This will open the image as a smart object, so I can go back and change these values later on if I want. Okay, now I have my photo as a smart object in the Layers panel. I want to duplicate this smart object, but I want it to be a new smart object and not link back to the previous one. So I can go up here to Layer, Smart Objects, New Smart Object via Copy. Or I could just right-click my layer and click New Smart Object via Copy. Now I have my photo in two different smart objects, and I can edit them individually in Camera Raw. To open up Camera Raw again, I'll just double-click the thumbnail for my layer on top. Now that I have a new duplicate raw image, I can feel comfortable with playing with these options. I like this image, but it looks a little too bright and overexposed. I want to bring out the details of the foreground a little more, especially this lady's jacket and face. I'll go to Exposure and bring it down to -0.5. I'll bring the contrast up to +30. I'll take the highlights down to -100. I'll keep the shadows at 0. I'll bring the whites up to +30. I'll keep the blacks at 0. I'll bring the clarity up to +50. And finally, I'll take the saturation down to -100. Then I'll click OK. Turning down the saturation made this black and white, but I don't intend to keep it that way. I want to keep the brightness levels of this image with the colors of my original image. So to blend them together, I'll click the Blend Mode Picker and go down to Luminosity. Now I'm getting all the detail without changing the color too much. This has made a nice contrast on my image, but I want to make her stand out from the background a bit more. So what I'll do is mask this layer, so it only affects the areas I want. I'll click the Layer Mask button. Then I'll invert the mask by hitting Ctrl-I on my keyboard. Now I can get a white brush and just paint in the areas I want to reveal. I want to focus on her upper half, so I'll just continue painting an outline. Then I'll fill my outline. And just do some touch-up here and there. Okay, there's a basic introduction to Camera Raw with a double raw conversion. We'll go over some more things in Camera Raw later on, but for now, that will do it for this video. I'll go over some more photo correction techniques in the next video.